In this segment, I'm going to just talk briefly about the IEEE 754 standard. We're only going to talk about how we represent a single precision number. IEEE 754 standard is a standard which is used to standardize the representation of numbers in various computers, as well as standardize the arithmetic operations of multiplication, addition, division, and subtraction in those computers. So the standard is basically to see that, hey, the different computers, whether using a VAX, a Cray computer, a PC, a Macintosh, that all those computers will be able to represent the numbers in a similar fashion. Same is the case with the arithmetic operations which we do on those computers. Now, there's a nice paper, and you can find this link in the PowerPoint presentation of this particular presentation here. So if you go to the keyword, the floating point on the numerical methods website, you will see a link to the PowerPoint. But you can also get it right from here if you just want to punch in the URL directly into your browser. This is a very good paper on what every computer scientist should know about floating point arithmetic. And in my opinion, that even if you're not a computer scientist, you can gain quite a bit of knowledge about floating point operations or floating point arithmetic from this particular paper. It's a long paper. It's about 150 to 175 pages long. I don't expect that you are going to go through all the 175 pages. But what I would like to see is that you skim through it, see some of the initial details, some of the summary details of the paper, and I think you will learn quite a bit about how this floating point arithmetic works and how the IEEE 754 standard works for floating point operations. And again, as I said, that we are limiting our discussion to the single precision number. We're not even talking about arithmetic operations, but just the single precision format, so that you get some good feel about, we already talked about the floating point representation in a hypothetical word or a hypothetical hypothetical 10-bit word. And here what we are trying to do is we are trying to use the 32 bits which are actually used for single precision in real life. How is that different? Now, one of the things which you see is that you have 32 bits for your single precision number. You're going to use 1 bit for the sign of the number. And then you use 8 bits for the biased exponent. And we'll talk about the biased exponent in a little bit. And then you use 23 bits for the mantissa. Now, what does that mean is that your minus 1 raised to the power s will then dictate, where s is the sign of the bit. It can be either a 0 or a 1. Will dictate whether it's a negative number or a positive number. The mantissa is 23 bits, which go right here. Those zeros and ones go right here. And what you're seeing here is that before the radix point here, you're seeing a 1. What does that mean? We know that when we do scientific notation, we use a non-zero number before the decimal point when we're talking about the base 10 number. So that non-zero number can be has to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9, depending on what the number is. But when we talk about binary numbers, the only non-zero number which we have is 1. So the 1 is automatically assumed that is before the radix point. So that's why you find out that you don't put that 1 in the mantissa part of the number at all. Because if it is already assumed, there's no need to store it. And you are saving some space and also increasing the accuracy of your numbers by doing that. Now, so far as the exponent is concerned, it's a biased exponent. What do we mean by biased exponent is that you'll have to subtract 127 from the exponent which has been stored here. What you're finding out here in the biased exponent is that there is no bit which is being used for negative exponents, because you won't get negative exponents for numbers. Let's suppose you have 2 to the power minus 50. How are we going to represent that in an exponent which has no bit for the sign of the exponent? And the way it is done is that you bias it and you subtract 127, which means that whatever number is being represented in the exponent, you subtract 127 from it to show that, hey, that's the real number which is being represented. Now, if you have the exponent as something, then you add 127 to it, and then you store it right here in the 8 bits of the bias exponent.